Hey there, mathematicians! It's Justin again. Mia's family members have been visiting and sharing some great multiplication and division fact strategies, but today, we've traveled to Gatlinburg, Tennessee to visit Mia's older cousin, Forrest, who happens to be Tulip's twin. Tulip helped us with our 2's, and Forrest here is going to help us with our 4's today. Gatlinburg is home to some beautiful mountains and amazing trails. In fact, we're about to set off on a hike right now. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to make connections to help you confidently multiply and divide by 4. Have your guided notes ready, and let's set off on our journey. Ready, Mia? Ready, Forrest? Ready, mathematicians? Well, let's go! Looks like Forrest found some worm-up problems for us to solve. Pause here to solve 2 times 7, 4 times 7, 2 times 10, and 4 times 10 in your guided notes. So 2 times 7 is 14, while 4 times 7 is 28, and 2 times 10 is 20, while 4 times 10 is 40. Forrest, I thought our lesson was supposed to be all about 4's. Why did we also solve problems with 2's? Oh, they're related fact families, like how you and Tulip are related. 2's and 4's each have their own sets of fact families, but since they're related, they can work together. But how? Forrest says we should check out the answers to our warm-up problems. Do you notice any patterns that might explain how 2's and 4's are related? Pause here and record your thinking. Since 4 is twice as much as 2, the answers we get when multiplying by 4 are twice as much as they are when multiplying by 2. Another way to say that is that the amounts are doubled. 28 is twice as much as, or double, 14. And 40 is twice as much as, or double, 20. But how does this help us with our 4's? Well, let's say we want to solve 4 times 12, but we aren't quite sure what the answer is. How could solving 2 times 12 first be helpful? If we know the answer to 2 times 12, then we can double that amount to figure out the answer to 4 times 12. Give it a try. Pause here to solve in your guided notes. Since 2 times 12 equals 24, 4 times 12 is double that, or 48. Hey, Forrest, where'd you go? Oh, you were looking for division problems. We know multiplication and division are inverse operations. So if we can use our knowledge of 2's and double the answer for multiplication, I wonder what we can do for division. Forrest found some division problems for us to solve. You are quite the forager, Forrest. Mathematicians, pause here to solve 12 divided by 2, 12 divided by 4, 20 divided by 2, and 20 divided by 4 in your guided notes. Okay, 12 divided by 2 equals 6, while 12 divided by 4 equals 3. And 20 divided by 2 equals 10, while 20 divided by 4 equals 5. Instead of doubling our answers like we did when multiplying by 4, what do you notice about our answers when dividing by 4? Our answers are half of what they were when dividing by 2. When we divide by 2, like 12 divided by 2, we're splitting the dividend in half, equaling 6 in each group. And when we divide by 4, there are more groups, which makes the amount in each group even smaller. We could think of it as splitting the dividend in half, and then in half again. When we divide by 4, our answer is half as much as it is when we divide by 2. So, Let's say we need to solve 24 divided by 4, but we want to try using our related facts to help. If we know what 24 divided by 2 equals, then we can split that amount in half to figure out the answer to 24 divided by 4. Give it a try. Pause here to solve in your guided notes. Since 24 divided by 2 is 12, 24 divided by 4 is half that amount, or 6. You may discover there are other strategies that work better for you with your 4's, like a multiplication table, skip counting, or remembering different fact families. And it's okay if you don't use the same strategy for every fact. Maybe you know 4 times 10 equals 40 because the digit in the 1's place shifts 10 times greater. Or maybe you know 48 divided by 4 is 12 because you know 12 times 4 is 48. Knowing your fact families is more than just memorizing, it's understanding the relationships between numbers. So, what have we learned today besides the fact that Forrest is a fantastic forager and fact finder? Well, now you know that 2's and 4's are related fact families. Multiplying by 4 is the same as multiplying by 2 and doubling the product, while dividing by 4 is the same as dividing by 2 and splitting the quotient in half. You also know that there are several strategies that can help you master your facts. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice multiplying and dividing by 4. Hey Forrest, do you know who's helping us with our next set of math facts? Felix! I wonder which fact he'll be helping with. Well, thank you for guiding us through our 4's today, Forrest. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, practice makes progress. Keep exploring those numbers, and I'll see you next time! Hey.